हेलो एवरीवन, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लुक एट द टॉपिक्स और वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ पीएचपी व्हिच इज़ ब्राउज़र कंट्रोल एंड डिटेंशन। सो बेसिकली ब्राउज़र कंट्रोल एंड डिटेंशन आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ पीएचपी एज वेल एज इन वेब डेवलपमेंट ऑल्सो। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल लुक एट वॉट इज ब्राउज़र कंट्रोल। सो ब्राउज़र कंट्रोल मीन्स इंश्योरिंग डेट अवर वेब पेज और वेब एप्लीकेशन बिहेव कंसिस्टेंटली एंड करेक्टली अक्रॉस डिफरेंट वेब ब्राउजर्स लाइक क्रोम, फायरफॉक्स, सफारी एंड अदर्स। इट इसेंशियल बिकॉज इच ब्राउजर में इंटरप्रेट एंड डिस्प्ले वेब पेजेस साइंटली डिफरेंटली। सो बाई कंट्रोलिंग हाउ अवर वेबसाइट वर्क इन ईच ऑफ दिस ब्राउजर वी कैन प्रोवाइड अ स्मूथ एंड यूनिफॉर्म एक्सपीरियंस for all our users. So let us look. So there are three methods of web browsing. So first of all, which is generating HTML and JavaScript. Second is AJAX, asynchronous JavaScript and XML. And third is browser control through Selenium. Okay. So what is importance of our this topic may which is browser control. So first efficiency. This increases the efficiency and reduces the manual efforts. The second is data access. It enables easy data access. Third is quality assurance. Means it ensures the better quality of a web application. For this time saving, it is very much time saving. And fifth is compatibility and sixth is interpretation. Integration. There are some use cases of browser control also. First is web scraping, second is automated testing, third is data entry automation, fourth is web monitoring, and etc. So here are one example of how we can write a code for browser control in our HTML. So first of all, we have to write a simple structure or of HTML, and what if we under the PHP tag as you seeing header, afterward location, then we have to give the location of the page for which we have to redirect it. So first of all, we can understand web browsing more is in more simple functions or more in simple words. So basically, suppose I have made a web page called addition and another web page called add list. So what I want that whenever I click on any item on addition, this item automatically add in another web page called main list, or I have directly redirected to main to list that listing page. So basically what I mean to say that whenever I click and on item on addition list addition, then item automatically redirected me to that listing page, and for that we have to write this code or this header code, and where the www.google.com is written, we have to give the location of our web page where we have to redirect it. So I think you understand in the web browser control easily. So now we can look at our today's another topic, which is browser detention. So browser detention is also a process of determining and identifying the web browsers and version that a visitor is using to access our website. This is also very important in terms of our PHP. So there are also and it is valuable because it allows us to customize our website to suit the capabilities and quirks of user browser, and also this help in delivering a more compatible, user-friendly and bug-free experience for our visitors. So why to detect a browser, that why we need to detect a browser, this is the first thing we have to look. So there are several reasons for that. The first is compatibility. By detecting the user's browser, we can tailor our website code and design to ensure it work correctly and look good on that specific browser. The second is feature support. Like different web browsers support various web technologies and features to upgrade degrees. By detecting the user browser, we can deliver content and functionalities that is compatible with their browser capabilities. The third is bug fixes, in which browser detection help us identify and address issue or bugs specific to certain browsers, ensuring a smoother user experience. And the third and the fourth last is analytics. Browser detection can be used to collect data on which browser our web visitors are using. This information can guide us to make decision about which browser to prioritize for testing and support. Okay, so this is all about why we need a browser detection. So there are also four method to detecting browser in PHP. First is using the server HTTP user agent. Second is using third party libraries. Third is using JavaScript for feature detection. And fourth is using server side framework. Okay, so now look at the simple example of how we write. How we write and browser detection code in our HTML, browser control only. We can write the code for this under our page, under our HTML page, or under PHP tag. So as you can see that after $ server HTTP user agent is written. So in this way we can write or detect the browsers. Okay, so there are also some libraries too for browser detection. First, like mobile detect, browser PHP, Broscape, browser detection with browser, parsen, us parsen php, and wurfl. Okay, so and there is also one term which is user agent header. So user agent detection is a technique used by web servers and web application to identify the type and version of a web browser and other client software. And this is similar like what is the meaning of our browser detention or browser detention and browser control. Okay, so basically in summary and to sum up, we can say that browser control and detention in PHP and in web development are very essential for creating website that are compatible, user friendly and consistent across various web browsers, ultimately provide a better experience for our websites. Okay. Thank you.